Oh, both teams prove that they can be in games with top teams in the nation.
Yeah, and, you know, Rowan, now you look at the difference, though, between the two teams. You mentioned, you know, nationally ranked. All those teams that we went down the list for Rowan in those five teams that made it, none of them are nationally ranked. You take a look at Emerson, yeah, like you said, they're 1-3 overall against NCAA tournament-bound teams, but every single one of those teams is nationally ranked. You take a look at St. Thomas. They're the number 13 nationally ranked team in the country, according to D3Hoops.com. It's Amherst, number 7 team. And then MIT, the number 12 team in the country, also an in-conference battle with Emerson. So they see them twice a year. And the first time, at home, Emerson took down MIT by 19 points, 84-65, a big victory. And then you take a look at when they had to go to MIT. MIT flipped the script and beat them by 23, 96-73. So you're right, Joe. Both these teams battle-tested, and tonight is really going to be an exciting night for some D3 men's hoops.
And I think one of the big wins that stands out for Rowan, too, is when they played Salisbury back on December 22nd. Salisbury was ranked 24, but that was the highest-ranking team that they played, according to D3 Hoops. But they got a 19-point victory there, 21-point victory there. Here in Glassboro, but it shows that all those games happened here in Glassboro, the non-conference opponent, when coming with Rosemont College, Salisbury. They did face Keene. They were the home team. They did play Keene State, but that was back at Franklin Marshall. But all of them, they were the home team, home crowd. Rowan always plays great here at home, and I think they're going to put on a great show tonight.
Definitely do as well. And Joe, just one last thing before we go to the national anthem and then do the starting lineups as well. You know, you take a look at this Rowan team. There's a key win in there that proves, you know, kind of turned Rowan's season around. Remember, they started off 4-0. And then after that, Rowan lost 3 in a row and dropped to 4-3. And you're kind of thinking, as a Rowan fan, what are we going to do? Like, what happened to our team? And then Rowan ends up beating Ramapo, you mentioned here, in Glassboro, New Jersey. That ended that three-game losing streak, and the next 11 games, the Profs record 10-1, and that's really where this team jump-started the rest of their season.
Absolutely. 10-1 the next 11 games, and obviously, I mean, not getting any, you know, ranking in the D3Hoops.com, but still the ability to really compete, really to show out, and I think the NJAC really topped off a season with the whipped cream, not the cherry on top. Cherry on top would be a couple wins in the NCAA tournament. But still, though, a topping, no doubt, that Glassboro has absolutely loved. And also, Rowan, bringing in the hardware this year. Not even just last year, this year, too. And hopefully they're going to continue as well, hopefully, for the national championship.
Well, let's hope for the best, Joe. And as you hear the buzz in the background, we're going to have to take a quick step off for the national anthem, and then they're going to do starting lineups. And in a few minutes, they'll be right back here in Esby Gymnasium with the first round of the NCAA Division III Men's Basketball Tournament between your Rowan University Profs and the Emerson College Lions. Make sure you guys stick around for all the basketball action right here on Rowan Radio 89.7 WGLS FM.
Good stuff. All right, Tyler, I think during the game, oh my God, I can't even hear. During the game, Mark will send it back to you for a legal ID. He'll say, oh, we'll throw it back to the station for a legal ID or for station identification. You're listening to Rowan Radio. And then that's when, obviously, you play the legal. Okay, just making sure. Oh, yeah, it's loud. Yeah.
Tyler. We'll come back home when it's time to send it. They can hear us over the live feed. Welcome back into the campus of Rowan University and SB Gymnasium in Glassboro, New Jersey for this NCAA first round action between the Rowan University Profs and the Emerson College Lions. Mark Astelli alongside Joe Stoffberger. We're about to get things underway right now with tip-off. We'll give you the starting lineups as the beginning of the game progresses. Deontay Baugh going up for it with number 23, Jared Houston. And Baugh wins the tip to De'Ron Curry. Rob DePersia driving in, kicks it out to his brother Nick. Spots up from three, and Rowan gets it going early. 3-0 advantage off the first shot from Nick DePersia.
And obviously you heard it right there. We could barely hear each other, but man, what a way to start the game. A three-pointer right in the corner.
Underneath with the ball is Houston. Houston trying to battle it for it with Baugh. Three-pointer. Off the back of the rim, no good. Profs get the rebound. Starting lineups for Rowan. Number 0, Rob DePersia. Number 1, Ramon Wright. Number 2, De'Ron Curry. Number 21, Nick DePersia. And number 30, Deontay Baugh. And speaking of Deontay Baugh, gets underneath the rim and puts in a layup. 5-0, Rowan.
Beautiful drop-off pass from Ramon Wright. He drove baseline, kicked it right to Deontay Baugh, was wide open in the paint.
Emerson College Lions, their starting lineup. Number 2, Trevor McLean, number 3, Jeffrey Gray, number 4, Jack O'Connor, number 10, Zach Waterhouse, and number 23, Jared Houston. Three-pointer from O'Connor, no good. Rebound brought down, though. Here's another three. Waterhouse hits it.
That's something that Emerson College does so well. Just throw the ball up and hope it goes in. Obviously, one of the best in the new MAC in draining them, but they throw up a lot, Mark.
Yeah, they do, as Rob DePersia's got it, gives it off to De'Ron Curry. Curry drives in, layup, no good. Rebound, Baugh put back off the backboard. Couldn't get it, brought down by Houston. Driving up the court is Gray, pass it out. Three-pointer from McLean, no good. Offensive board from Waterhouse. And he's called for the travel. It's a turnover on the Lions.
And that's nothing that he could have done about that one. Waterhouse came down with it. Obviously, he set his feet, but then he fell. It was just the momentum. It took him. You're going to get a travel every time.
Ramon Wright brought it up the court. He'll hand it back to De'Ron Curry. He drives in the lane. Gets stripped going up. It's a clean steal. And here comes Emerson on the fast break. Layup almost swatted away. But how about the finger roll from Jeffrey Gray?
Just off the fingertips of Baugh. Looked like he got a piece of it. But just missing it was Baugh. Would have been an emphatic block.
Nick DePersia, layup no good, but he's fouled going to the hole, and he'll go to the line for two free throws. So Joe, already both teams trying to set the fast tempo 5-5 score right now, 17:46 left to go in the first half. And we've already seen Emerson try and hit it from beyond the arc multiple times, which is something we should expect from them the rest of the game.
Nick DePersia misses the first one, but yeah, you're right. And with Rowan, whenever they get the rebound, they're always looking up. That's their first thing that they do. The first instinct that they do is just look up, because knowing they could have anybody streaking down to the bucket for a possible fast break score.
And Nick DePersia's second free throw goes down, so it gives the Prowls a one-point lead, 6-5, early in the first half.
Might be a short lead, but a lead, no doubt. You never want to play from behind.
Houston to McLean for three, and you cannot leave this Lions team open. He nails it, and it's a two-point lead for Emerson. Rob gets stripped, and they're going to call a foul. See who they award it to. Number four, Jack O'Connor, gets his first foul. Team second. Ball inbounded right to Nick DePersia. He gives it to Ramon Wright. Wright looking. Screen set by Ba. Out to Curry. Curry out to Rob DePersia. Lions playing good perimeter defense. DePersia floater, no good. Rebound. McLean comes down with it and brings it up the court. McLean driving in. Layup, no good. Great defense by the NJAC Defensive Player of the Year, Ramon Wright. Dribble move behind the back by Nick DePersia. Step back three off the rim. No good. Ba for the rebound. Can't get it. But Nick DePersia with the steal. It's Rob driving to the basket. Swatted away. But they are going to call a foul. Looked like Jeffrey Gray, the culprit, underneath the basket. And Rob DePersia goes to the line for two. It's actually going to be Jared Houston who's awarded the foul.
The football team right under the bucket letting them know that he got the foul called on him, and he also clapped too. But, I mean, what strength by Rob DePersia, fighting through the contact, still trying to put it up, and gets two at the line in return, makes the first one.
Well, if you're Rowan, you don't want anybody else at the line but Rob DePersia. 78.9% free throw percentage on the team. That's a ninth in the NJAC this season. He sinks both and ties the game at 8 points apiece. Pass to McLean. We know he can shoot the three. Dribbles in. Jumper. No good. Rebound brought down by Ramon Wright. O'Connor goes for the steal. Doesn't get it. Wright brings it over half court. Gives it to Nick DePersia. Deron Curry. Floater. Got it. And the Rowan gets the lead right back. McLean has the ball for Emerson. Looking around, Houston trying to set the screen on Nick DePersia. Ball handed off to O'Connor. O'Connor pass to Gray. Jeffrey Gray trying to back down Rob DePersia. Spot up three from Waterhouse. No good. Rebounded by Rob DePersia. He passed to his brother Nick, who gets it over half court. He'll slow it down and actually get called for a travel. So a turnover by the Profs.
Early on, we think that the mismatches are going to be a problem for the Profs, but obviously they're sticking right to Emerson. A timeout is called. Now the Profs trying to, I guess, slow things up.
Looks like it's a 30-second timeout, so we're going to keep things here. But, Joe, what's the one thing that you can point out that you're seeing from Rowan right now early on in this first half?
Run and gun. Fast break. Try to get as many buckets as you can, and don't let Emerson get set. Emerson has been doing a great job on defense so far, not even just with this game, but for the whole entire season. Don't let them get set and make them panic on defense so that you can nail an open bucket, hopefully swing it around somewhere or even throw it inside to get an easy bucket.
Well, we've seen already so far Emerson not shooting very well inside the paint, but from beyond the arc, they're doing a great job. So far, 1-for-2 from beyond the arc is Emerson. I'm sorry, 2-for-6. But think about it, they only have 8 points. So 2 3-pointers, you take those away, they got 2 points. Prof's got an 8-point lead. And both of those 3-pointers were open shots. There was not a Prof within 10 feet of a line.
Keep them buckets outside of the rim instead of them going in. and you might win this ball game. It might just have to come down to that perimeter defense, that three defense might get you the win.
And there's a big steal from Rob DePersia, and then he gets stripped, and Waterhouse goes up, layup, and it's good. How about the defense right there from the Lions? They got it stripped away and then strip it right back. 10-10 ball game. Lamont Wright driving in. Pass, is it deflected? No, it's not.
Might have got deflected from the Emerson Lions team, but then went right back to Rowan right before it went out of bounds. And still the Lions will be inbounding it.
Gray gets the inbound for the Lions. Checking into the game for Emerson, number 5, Nate Martin. Gray, guarded by Nick DePersia. O'Connor. Underneath to Houston. Houston dishes it out. Martin out wide to Waterhouse. Waterhouse driving. And they're going to call a foul on Deron Curry.
Must have just been the slightest contact, but they might be calling it today. And Rowan's has to adjust to it. You know, it's all about the game of adjustments. And you know, if they're going to call a little some of these small fouls, you got to play off them now.
That's Deron's first foul of the game. Team's second.
It's a great switch there by the profs.
Martin has the ball, driving in, fakes it, jumper, fadeaway, no good. Rebound, Rowan Wright, he passed it to Rob DePersia, then he gets run into, and that's a foul on Jared Houston. How about the smart play and basketball IQ from Rob DePersia?
Manu Ginobili, however long his career was, he's been doing that all his whole entire career. And so has Rob DePersia. That's two fouls now for Jared Houston. But he knew Houston was right behind him. He knew Houston was going to be running. So he said, you know what? Let's stop. Let's get him into some foul trouble. And then let's go.
That's a big deal because Jared Houston, that's his second foul as Rob DePersia answers on the offensive end. Deron Curry with the steal. And look at that. Two buckets within 5 seconds for Rowan. And it's a 4-point lead. How about that sequence? Jack O'Connor for the Lions. Layup, he got it to go.
Not an easy thing to do to get it right over Rowan Wright. One of the lengthiest players out there on the court. Got it right over the fingertip. There's now another big man, Austin Carney, in for the profs.
As I was saying, with Jared Houston getting his second foul, head coach Bill Curley elects to sub him out to preserve him for later in the game. So this is the profs' opportunity to get it done underneath. Jeffrey Gray got the ball, running around the screens, Waterhouse. Here's Gray driving in for the layup, swatted away by Austin Carney. Nate Martin gets it out. Jeffrey Gray, jump shot, no good, and it gets stuck between the backboard and the rim. And Austin Carney having a little bit of trouble trying to get it out. I'm sure he's going to get a little bit of laughter from the bench over there.
It's got to be. That might be a little bit of a bad sign for Emerson, getting it stuck there. So the play resets.
Play resets. It'll be Emerson ball. Prof still up by two, 14-12. 13:51 left to go in the first half. Martin has it. And he gets called for the travel.
A little bit of an easy call there to make, and he knew it too. He stopped as the whistle blew. He kind of looked like, oh, all right, I can't do that.
Lack of discipline right there from Martin results in a turnover, and it's Prof's possession. Rowan Wright's got it beyond the three-point line, drives in, pass underneath to Carney. Hook shot, no good, rebound by Gray. Emerson trying to take it on the fast break. O'Connor driving in, reverse layup, no good, rebound put back. And he got his own shot.
The previous play with Carney, although the ball didn't go in, you still have to like Rowan, realizing that Houston has a seat on the bench. Might as well go inside with your own size.
Connor Dickerson with the layup along the baseline. And Rowan's lead restored.
Dickerson off the bench all year has been tremendous for this Profs team. And like that bucket, really helping out the Profs.
And then an and one from Jeffrey Gray. So he makes the bucket, and now he'll go to the line for a chance at a three-point play.
Quickly, Ba coming back in, and I guess trying to keep fresh bodies out there, at least for the big man. Houston not in now, but still you know, wanting to keep a lot of size in there with Baugh and Carney as the free throw nets.
Free throw goes down, and Emerson gets the lead 17-16. 12:55 left to go in the first half. Rob DePersia drives, kicks. Jermon Wright, it's Connor Dickerson. We've already seen him go baseline once. He goes baseline again. Underneath Jermon Wright, gets stripped, and no foul called as Emerson gets the rebound. Gray calling for McLean, guarded by Dickerson. McLean comes across half court, drives in, and Dickerson with the strip. And they're going to say it hit off a prop last. It'll stay with the Lions.
Profs, I think, on offense might just need to slow it down. Although we've been talking about fast break points, instead this one, unless you have a clear lane, do it.
Dickerson, the ball! He went for the alley-oop slam and just couldn't put it down. That would have been a highlight reel dunk for sure. O'Connor fakes the three, puts it up again. No good rebound, Nick DePersia. Foul call going up. And it'll be Prof's ball.
Yeah, it was hit off the top beam, but man, that might have been the best non-dunk I've ever seen that didn't go in. The roof would have blown off of Esby.
That would have brought the house down. Absolutely. And Nick DePersia spots up from three. No good off the front of the rim. Rebound, Ramon Wright goes in for the rebound, and it's called for the foul on Jeffrey Gray. His first.
I think that just a little lack of discipline by that play for Wright. Just couldn't force the props to get that foul.
You can hear this crowd still in this one. Still early in the game. 17-16, 12 minutes left to go in the first half. And we're going to take a quick pause for station identification. Listen to Rowan Profs Basketball. Game so far, Joe. Right now, back and forth action. Both teams being pretty disciplined in the foul department. Only four on Emerson, three on Rowan. And right now, it seems as though Emerson's got the momentum.
Yeah, right now, I think the Profs just need to find a groove somewhere, whether it's beyond the arc, going inside, the mid-range, or anywhere. Just find a groove somewhere so that you can shoot there all game long and know it's going to go in. I think right now you got to start taking some from beyond the arc and try to give the Emerson Lions a little bit of their own medicine.
Yeah, Profs need to find a groove in the worst way. It's only a one-point game, but here at home, if you start getting on a roll, the crowd's going to get behind you, it's going to get loud, and Emerson's going to start struggling.
And that was the key. When Rowan wasn't hot, in that New Jersey City game, the NJAC championship game, Rowan wasn't doing that well just because of the fact that the crowd really wasn't on their side. They can't feed off the energy. It looked like the baseball team for Jersey City was trying to get into the heads of the Profs players on the far side of the court whenever they went over there. But they bounced back. They found a groove and obviously fought back, won. And got an NJAC championship out of it. They were down six with 3 minutes left.
The Profs, certainly one of those teams that are never out of the game. Me and you talked about this before. I talked about it also when I spoke to Rob DePersia yesterday. You know, he basically just kind of told me, we feel like we can win every game. We can beat any team in the country. And obviously from that soundbite you brought up that Rowan Athletics put up with Coach Joe Crispin saying, look, if they hit a three, that's fine. We'll beat them in overtime. Just don't foul them. Just shows you the kind of camaraderie and the confidence this coach has in his team.
And Ramon Wright said that the goal of a national championship is not far-fetched. He thought about it. He said he thought about it a little bit earlier and was like, I don't know. And then they started winning games, eventually winning the championship on a four-game winning streak. And then he's like, all right. He goes, this ain't far-fetched. This isn't out.
And a technical foul has been called on Emerson. Looks like the foul doesn't say who it's called on. But Ryan Legler goes to the line and nails it, and we got a tie ball game. Up on the scoreboard, it says the foul was on number one. There is no number one on the Emerson College Lions roster. Interesting. Well, it doesn't matter, Joe. We got a tie game right now, 17-17.
Profs will take it, and obviously they have one of their best free throw shooters out there on the court right now with Ryan Legler. Also can stroke it from beyond the arc.
And I think that's the goal Coach Crispin is looking for. He's trying to get his team hot from beyond the arc. Here's Gray. Gray fadeaway jumper. Ball on his face. No good. Rebound Nick DePersia.
That's all you're going to do. Every time they put up a shot, make sure a hand is there. You might not get a block, but as long as the hand's there, you know, you should be fine on defense.
And Nick DePersia from three. No good. Here comes O'Connor. O'Connor spot up jumper. Didn't get it. Ba did a great job with the shot.
That's two straight possessions that Ba has just got a hand up, not a block, but still having defensive presence.
Off to Marmon right. Pass underneath. Ba trying to use his big frame underneath. Instead, dished it out. Here's Marmon right driving in. He gets swatted from behind. And Emerson comes away with it. The Lions. That's number 32, but once again, no number 32 on the roster we were given. So Emerson with the block, and now Nate Martin. Layup, no good. Excuse me, Nate Martin was able to knock it down, and it's a 19-17 lead for Emerson. Connor Dickerson, baseline, reverse layup, no good. Nick DePersia almost steals it from Gray. Gray passing underneath to Martin. Ba with the defense. Great job to contest it and force him to miss.
And once again, Deontay Ba showing off where he gets all of his skill from, and it's on the defensive side of the ball.
Ball going out of bounds. It's going to be Emerson College ball. And the Profs faithful not happy about that one. But solving the mystery of who number 32 is, it's actually Ben Holden. He's number 26 on the roster, but maybe he forgot his jersey. We don't know the story behind that, but he's number 32 tonight. So number 32, officially Ben Holden. Ball inbounded. Here's Gray. To Holden. Back to Gray. Two-point game. Emerson with the lead. Gray out wide. McLean driving in. Hands it off to Holden again. Holden. Looking for the post move, no good. Deontay Bach continues to be a force underneath. Actually, that time it's Tariq Robinson. Deron Curry for three, got it! And that's a Rowan lead.
The Profs on the defensive side, Legler and Robinson, they didn't bite every time they tried to put up a shot. That's gonna also be a key for tonight's game. Not biting on a pump fake. Right now, before that, we've seen all the shots go up with just one shot and nothing else. But now they're trying to do the pump, and they're not biting.
And O'Connor went in, got fouled by Matt Green. It's his first. Rowan's fourth as a team. And they'll inbound the ball. So Matt Green into the game for Rowan, as well as Ryan Legler, Deron Curry, Connor Dickerson, and Tariq Robinson. Gray for three. Airballs it. And the Profs fans are letting them hear about that one. And O'Connor and Matt Green jawing back and forth underneath the basket. Referee had to come in and say something to both of them. Deron Curry gets the ball from Robinson, who inbounded it.
Matt Green, known for a little bit of jawing back and forth. He was going at it with the baseball team of Jersey City last game. Curry for three.
And Deron Curry, back-to-back three-pointers. And Joe, we've seen this before.
Well, he's hot, he's hot. Shooter's gonna shoot, Mark.
Shooter's gonna shoot, and the last time we saw this, Curry hit three straight threes in a row. I wouldn't be surprised if the next possession he takes it down and tries it again. The jumper goes in, courtesy of McLean.
Keep feeding Deron Curry.
Legler to Dickerson. Profs with a two-point lead, 23-21. Hands it off, Matt Green looking. Green, fadeaway jumper, no good. Robinson with the rebound attempt, and they're going to call a foul on the rebound on Tariq. His first foul. That is the team's fifth. Cross fans really loving the contact here tonight.
And you knew this, it wasn't going to be easy for Emerson coming into this gym. We know that Rowan is hosting, and this is a huge matchup for the Profs, but obviously Rowan faithful always showing out.
Martin to McLean. They're leaving McLean open for three. Better be careful. Rebound brought down by Holding, and a double dribble. Turnover again on the Lions.
Man, this crowd is absolutely electric. After talking with Ramon Wright, one of the things that he said, he goes, we don't have a student section, but it's always electric at Esby. Matt Green came right in, and we were like, the whole thing is a student section. This whole entire gym filled with students and parents. Absolutely unbelievable.
There is not an empty seat in the house. Ron Curry stays hot.
Keep feeding them.
Not from beyond the arc, but this time slashes in to the paint and gets the layup to go. 8 unanswered points for Duran. And Holding, no good. Rebound. He gets it again. Stripped. Still gets it. Now O'Connor going in. Reverse layup. No good. And then he's fouled. Tariq Robinson got the rebound. O'Connor got a little excited. Wrapped him up. And it's a foul on Jack O'Connor. His second. And he might have to take his seat, Joe, if head coach Bill Curley wants to be careful about it.
There's a lot of now players getting into some foul trouble. It's not good for the Lions. Good for the Profs, though. That, I mean, that's, you know, you have your critical players for this team, and now getting a few fouls here, a few fouls there. It just gives more for not just the team, but more for the star players to take a seat.
Yeah, and right now, we talked about it the last timeout. Emerson had the momentum, but coming out of that timeout, that was a long delay, Joe. And it looked like the game went back to 50-50. And now Rowan, courtesy of Deron Curry, has seized control of the momentum. And I think that's why head coach Bill Curley had to call a timeout.
Deron Curry, his last 6 shots, he's made 5 of them. That's on the up, on the down for the Lions. 1-7 in their last seven shots that they put up. The defense really stepping up here the last couple of minutes.
Not to mention, to start the game, they were hot from three. In their last 6 three-point attempts, the Lions 1-6.
I think they're also just letting them try to shoot, too. I mean, McLean had an open 3. Robinson saw him and said, nah, forget it. I'm just going to go back to the paint. He shot it, and it clanked off the rim.
And here's Deron Curry, bringing it up the court. Screen set by Ba, step back. Ba, another screen. Curry driving in, trying to use the layup, no good. And then they're gonna call a travel coming out, and it's gonna be cross ball again.
And Robinson was there inside, showing off his post moves just a little bit, but he gave it right back to Curry. Curry drove in. He's not afraid of contact. It's as simple as that.
And Tariq Robinson's the one that sets the screen. Keep confusing with Deontay Bob. Both very tall, 6'8", 6'7". Really can't tell them apart sometimes. Driving in, Curry, how about it? And he looks at the student section and says, let me hear you. Curry gets screened. Great with it. Profs have a 6-point advantage. Martin to Holding. Holding over to number 14, Justin Ventura, who came in. Now Gray underneath does a great job, and he rolled his ankle. And he is hobbling up to half court, and he looks like he may be calling for a sub. Actually, he might have waved him off, said, I'm all right.
Wow, what a play from Gray. I mean, it would have been a big loss for the Lions team if he hopped off or was subbed out. But immediately putting up to head coach Bill Curley and said, hey, I'm good, don't sub me.
Well, you saw him roll the ankle and his face is grimacing as he tries to defend Matt Green. Pass underneath, Robinson called for the offensive foul and the charge.
He got very close to the restricted area on that one. I don't know about that, Mark.
It's one of those close calls, but the referee says it's on Robinson, his second. But obviously, Emerson did a good enough job setting the feet underneath the rim. Gray will inbound. Jeffrey Gray, of course, big component in this Emerson Lions team. First team all NUMAC on the season. Nate Martin open for three. He's calling for it. He gets it. Drives in, free throw line jumper. Ryan Legler hand in his face and put him off. Great defense from Legs. Matt Green for three. Off the rim and rebounded by Gray.
I mean, that was a fantastic look for Green, and I don't fault him for taking that one.
Nothing wrong with him taking that three. Gray spots up from three, no good. Holding tries to save it, he does. Martin drives in, jumper, got it. How about the great play and the awareness to keep the ball in bounds by Holding, a good hustle play. And sometimes that's what it takes.
Sometimes, and that's a dangerous play too, because that could go right into the hands of the profs, but the Emerson Lions take advantage.
Ball deflected and taken up by Gray. Layup by Waterhouse, and we got a tie ball game.
Just like that, a four-point swing gives the, you know, a tie ball game.
27-27. Pass underneath, Robinson was open, and they called a foul as Matt Green drove in to make the pass. It is Emerson's sixth team foul, and Green is not going to go to the line. He thought he was going to the line, and so did a lot of people, but it's going to be an inbound play from Rob DePersia. You hear the Rowan chant going on inside Esby right now.
Getting everybody fired up for this possession.
Here's Ramon Wright to Deron Curry. Now Boz in, he sets the screen. Nick DePersia kicks it out. Ramon Wright open for three, doesn't take it. Takes a step in, misses the jumper brought down by Waterhouse. That's Ventura. Ventura gave it to Gray. Now to Waterhouse.
Vet move there by Rob DePersia. What a steal.
Big steal. Now Nick DePersia lobbed to Ramon Wright, and he missed the layup. Oh, what a pretty play it would have been.
That all started with a great play by Rob DePersia. After getting behind on Gray, goes to the corner knowing Waterhouse was wide open for three. Instead, when he goes up for it, strips him. Couldn't be converted.
Jeffrey Gray got the ball. Tie game, 27-27. Still, Rob DePersia, another steal. And he kept his balance after being almost tripped up. 4.5 minutes left to go in the first half. Rob goes around the screen, underneath Ramon Wright, misses the layup. Rob goes for another steal, couldn't get it. Ventura to Gray. Gray, spot up jumper, and in and out. Deontay Baugh with the rebound. Curry couldn't keep it in.
Already Rob DePersia tonight, four steals. Getting the ball back whenever possible. And he's got an eye for the ball.
Certainly does. Three-pointer from Martin. No good, but he's fouled.
Might have just been inside the two, the three-point arc.
It is two. Referee signals it's a two. So
That's big, because instead of 3 points, it could just be two if all free throws are made.
Yeah, Martin going to the line for Emerson. Takes a few dribbles, puts up the first free throw, and drops it down. Martin on the year, looking at his free throw percentage, shooting about 69.6%, almost 70% from the charity stripe. Takes another few dribbles. Puts up the second. Knocks that one down too, a 2-point lead for Emerson. Rob DePersia, guarded by Ventura. Pass to his brother Nick. Nick fakes the three, drives in, step back jumper. No good, rebounded by Gray. Gray's pass up to Martin, layup. No good as Ba gets the rebound. Matt Green now has it. Green with possession, guarded by Martin. behind the back. We've seen that move before. Rob DePersia driving in, kicked out to Deron Curry. Screen from Rob. Deron, spot up three off the rim. And Gray keeps it in, and how about that again? The hustle from this Emerson Lions team is amazing. Jeffrey Gray, screen set by Holden. Gray's got it, trying to back down DePersia. Out to McLean from beyond the arc, no good. Rebound Deron Curry. Rob DePersia streaking up the court, a three on three. Rob, layup, no good. And then a push in the back. See if it's on Rob. Let's see if it's against Rob going up for the shot. Is it a shooting foul? We still don't know if it's a shooting foul, but there is a timeout on the floor. Profs down 29-27. Still no signal if it's a full or a 30-second. So to keep it safe, we're going to keep it here. Make sure you don't miss any of this exciting first-round action right here on Rowan Radio 89.7 WGLS-FM.
I think right now Rowan is just really daring Emerson to shoot the three. They're just daring them. They're letting them take it. And the last couple of possessions, they haven't gone in.
Well, you look at the stats. Emerson started off 2-for-6 from the three-point line. Since then, have increased to 2-for-11. So since the last time we talked about it, they've missed 5 in a row. That's good news for the Profs. But look, this Emerson team has a lot of good shooters. You take a look at the three-point percentage for this team. Trevor McLean, who made 1 3 so far tonight, he's 1-for-4. On the season, Joe, he shoots over 50% from beyond the arc, which is why it's so dangerous. If he gets hot, it might be a long night for Rowan. Then you look at Nate Martin, he can hit it from three, 44.8%. Zach Waterhouse, 42%. And the list goes on. They even have Jack O'Connor, who shoots over 40% from three.
I think the opportunity for second chance points really needs to be improved. No, only one offensive rebound, as Ba can't make the first of the 1-1.
Ba couldn't make it, so we're still at a two-point game. Ball with Martin, jumper off the rim, no good. Nick DePersia to Matt Green. Back to Nick DePersia. He'll take it from three. And it hit the front of the rim, I think. I couldn't tell if it airballed or hit the front of the rim. Doesn't matter. It didn't drop. Gray hands it off to Ventura. Ventura falling over, makes the pass to Gray. It's holding. Green almost with a steal. McLean fakes it. Jumper. No good. Rebound. Holding. Takes a dribble, puts it back up, and gets it to go. And one. Deontay Ball called for the foul. And he'll go to the line for a chance at the three-point play.
Another offensive rebound, more points, and an opportunity for one more point here with a made free throw. On the offensive side of the Profs, Nick DePersia can't get it going tonight, and that's one of the names that usually does have it every night. 1-for-6 tonight from the field, only 4 points tonight.
Free throw at the back of the rim, so he can't convert the three-point play. Profs down by 4. Rob DePersia drives in, layup, kisses it off the glass and in. And it's McLean with the ball for Emerson, 31-29. We're approaching the 2-minute mark of the first half. McLean gets stripped. Green keeps it in, and Nick DePersia gets it. Finds Rob driving in. Gets in, gets tripped up by Martin going in, and he'll go to the line, I believe, for a 1-1.
Mark, you said it, making second half adjustments is the key for the Profs. Profs have 1,011 points in the first half this year. The travel's called. In the second half, 1,200, almost 1,300, 1,280 points. In the second half, that's a 269-point difference from the first half. So basically 270 points have gone down more than the first half in the second half.
Here's the Profs. Matt Green fakes a three, drives in on Gray. Spin move off the glass, no good.
It's an and. Another good-looking shot from Matt Green, but just couldn't get it down.
McLean driving in, gets the layup to go. Green went for the big block and couldn't get it. And I have to mention one more bucket for Nick DePersia. He's got 4 points tonight. One more point, and he ties for fifth all-time on the all-time scoring list in Rowan history. 2 points, and he reaches fourth place. And there it is, and there's the bucket. Nick DePersia officially jumps into, fifth place, not fourth place, jumps into fifth place in Rowan basketball history when it comes to points scored all-time.
And Mark, we're both seniors, and so is Nick DePersia. We've seen some great shooting and moves just like that, stepping around the defender and putting it in. We've seen it all 4 years here, Rowan.
Nick DePersia with the little Euro step, and he's got the props back into this game, and it's tied 33-33, 36.9 seconds left to go in the first half. It's a 30-second timeout, so we're going to keep things here. We're also under 2 minutes. So 36 seconds left to go, 36.9 to be exact. And we know that Emerson's going to come down with the ball. Obviously, they'll probably try and waste that clock down as much as possible. And then the props, we're presuming, will probably get the last shot of the half.
And right now, it's Deron Curry really leading this props team. 14 points tonight. A rebound, a steal, hot on offense. There's no doubt. Curry has the ability to heat up whenever. It's probably the last name. That's how he gets the reason for hot so much. But I think in the second half, if Curry's going to be hot like he is in the first half, you keep feeding him.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised if Deron Curry stayed hot throughout this game. Let's hope he does. Right now, he's not on the court. Ball inbounded to Jeffrey Gray. He's got it for Emerson. Once again, 33 all. 30 seconds left to go in the first half. Pass underneath. Houston to Martin. Back to Houston. Ball going out. And that is going to be a backcourt violation.
That was a smart play there from Emerson and Jack O'Connor, to be exact. They didn't touch the ball so much. They didn't touch it when it went into the backcourt, just so that it took all that time off for Rowan. It doesn't matter, though. They would have got the last shot.
And Rowan subs in the shooters. Ryan Legler coming in. Nick DePersia already in. Rob DePersia is still in there. Austin Carney, he can spot it from three. And Connor Dickerson can hit the three as well. So we got 12 left in the first half. Make it 10 seconds now. Rob driving in. Layup around the rim. No good. Rebound. Carney can't get the and one, but he'll go to the line for two.
And just wanting the profs to take the lead is probably the thoughts of head coach Joe Crispin. Just going into halftime with a lead would be tremendous, but Austin Carney coming up big here this first round of the NCAA basketball championship tournament. Carney last game, 14 points and 8 rebounds. Once again, all coming from off the bench.
Carney misses the first free throw, and that makes the props 4-for-9 from the line tonight, which is not what you want to hear if you're a Rowan props fan. This for the lead. Carney to put up his second free throw. Goes up, in and out, but back in again. That's a lead for Rowan, 34-33, 4.3 left in the first half. Emerson gonna try and get a bucket before the buzzer sounds. Here's Martin, gets open. 3 seconds, two on the clock. Loses his footing, and how about the defense right there from Rowan to make sure they don't even get a shot off.
And not even just the defense in the front court, but in the back court of Nick DePersia having just waste time and almost get a shot clock violation. Bill Curley right at the referees before going into halftime, and he wanted a foul on that one.
Yeah, Bill Curley certainly not happy. I'll tell you what, Coach Joe Crispin is pretty happy, probably would be happier if they had a bigger lead, but I'm sure he'll take the 1 point lead going into halftime, 34-33. And Joe, just before we send it to a quick break, what's the one thing Rowan needs to improve on coming out in the second half?
Get Nick DePersia hot. That's one of the things that, you know, all year that we've seen from Nick DiPersia, drain it wherever on the court. And I think if you get him going, it's a dangerous, dangerous ball game.
Nick DiPersia, one of the senior leaders on this props team. And as of right now, he's got 6 points. And don't forget, he also jumped into fifth place on the all-time scoring list in Rowan men's basketball history. With that being said, we're going to take a quick step off for halftime. We'll be back in about 14 minutes more. Props basketball, 34-33. Rowan got a one-point lead heading into halftime. We'll be right back right here on Rowan Radio 9.7 WGLS FM.
At Rowan University, we are committed to a healthy, safe, and supportive community.
It's on us to create an environment where everyone feels and is safe.
To create an environment in which sexual assault is unacceptable.
Sexual violence is more than just a crime against individuals.
It threatens our families. It threatens our communities.
It's on us to do something about it.
To hold our friends accountable for their actions.
To stop being a bystander to the problem of sexual assault.
When we see something wrong, we should not look the other way.
1 in 4 women,
1 in 16 men,
will experience some form of sexual assault during their college career.
It's on us to look out for one another.
To recognize that sex isn't sex unless you have consent.
To get a friend home, safe.
Less than 5% of rapes are reported to law enforcement.
It's on us to support survivors of sexual violence.
And to never blame them.
To start the conversations that are difficult.
To take reports of sexual assault seriously.
It's on us to promote a culture of respect.
To treat women with respect.
To treat men with respect.
It's on us, all of us, to stop sexual assault.
Hello, I'm Dan Gilmore, Director of Athletics at Rowan University. The primary goal of our department is to develop you, the student athlete, in all aspects of life. Rowan Athletics is committed to your success on the field, in the classroom, and as citizens of high moral character and service. Our mission defines the commitment. We exist to purposely foster a selfless environment that cultivates community, embraces learning, and enhances excellence in sport and life.
I am a prof.
We are dedicated to the pursuit of excellence.
And committed to helping others achieve their fullest potential.
As scholars, athletes, leaders, and members of society.
Our department and the members within
are devoted to enhancing opportunities for success and competitive greatness.
I am a prof.
We are committed to developing a spirit of unity and belonging in the athletic department for those we serve.
We encourage diversity and inclusion.
And create identity by bringing together members of our campus, alumni, and local communities through athletics and service.
I am a prof.
We hold ourselves to the highest standards of integrity.
Through actions of respect, honesty, and fair play.
We strive to behave ethically towards others.
And convey expectations of high moral character.
We are committed to each other and respect the differences in others.
Our individual successes strengthen the whole.
And we support one another in our endeavors as we each share a common goal.
I am a prof.
Education is the forefront of our existence.
We develop a culture where lifelong learning is a priority.
We support each other and our student athletes in the quest for self-improvement and academic success.
To uphold the mission, Rowan Athletics Department will use its core values as guidance in actions both on and off the field.
Across divisions, sports, championships, and schools, for nearly 500,000 student athletes, college sports create lifelong opportunity, and that starts with education. We've raised the academic bar, so more are earning degrees, creating healthier campuses by working with the nation's brightest minds, and making sure more have the chance to succeed and are supported on their journey. But beyond the numbers, it's about opportunity, and we're working to provide it for every student athlete.
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor.
It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect. It's the name of the game.
Don't you worry, my child. Everything's gonna be just fine. Little darling, you keep on walking. Cause I ain't never gonna leave your side.
As kids fall in love with sports, our universities are working every day to keep college sports safe. So you can watch them play with a little less worry and a little more joy.
It's not about where you were born. It's not about your gender. Or the color of your skin. Or whether you're rich, poor, or in the middle. No matter what you play, if you have the skill and drive to succeed in school and in sports, we'll provide the opportunity.
Label me.
You know you want to.
Don't be shy.
You do it behind my back.
So say it to my face.
You don't know me. You know what I am?
I'm a pitcher.
I'm a striker.
I'm a point guard.
I'm a linebacker.
I'm a setter.
Shortstop.
High jumper.
Wrestler.
Defender.
Goalie.
Student.
Student athletes.
That's who we are.
On and off the court, we're focused on creating lifelong opportunity. And that starts with education. More college athletes are earning degrees than ever before, but we've still got work to do. That's why we're raising the bar for incoming freshmen, so they're prepared when they get to campus. And why teams can't play in championships unless they make the grade. Education matters. And putting academics first creates a pathway to a lifetime of opportunity. When all eyes are on the court, we're focused on what matters most, preparing college athletes for a lifetime of opportunity. After the buzzer, off the court, it's about education and working to earn a degree. Creating healthier campuses through groundbreaking research and policies. And a fair shot so dreams can stay on track. United as an association, we've got work to do. We're building a pathway to lifelong opportunity.
When you're in college, you kind of find out who you are. And throughout your 4 years, you develop yourself with all the different experiences, which leads into dedicating yourself to your community, to your family. So when you're a senior, you're coming out a well-rounded person.
College has given me the flexibility to pursue my passions and my interests outside of the classroom and outside of the court or field. I've had the ability to get into different activities and organizations, and I've recreated my identity for myself aside from just being an athlete.
Getting to be involved in a lot of different things, ranging from obviously being a student athlete to getting involved with my campus and my community, and not only being allowed to do that, but being encouraged to do that.
The opportunity to be able to study what I wanted to and continue to play the sport I love, to have the professors know me on a personal level, all of those things came together very nicely in one package in Division III.
Being a part of the different activities and organizations that I've been a part of, I'm actually able to see myself where I'm like, hey, I actually can make a change. I'm one person that can make a difference. It really helps you develop thinking from other people's perspectives and looking at problems from outside the box.
Division III has helped me to develop teamwork skills, critical thinking skills, time management skills.
I've definitely learned how to really be myself. I found out, yes, I am actually a good leader, and yes, I can actually put myself forward because I am good enough. I can do it.
Coming in to college, I just wanted to get good grades and to do well. But it also made me realize that I have a lot of different career goals, and I've learned so much about myself that I was always like growing and changing.
When I got to college, it forced me to step up and become more of a leader. And I think that was something I had the capability of doing. And
forever grateful that being at a Division III school gave me that opportunity.
You have to dedicate your time in the classroom. You have to dedicate your time in the gym, on the field, on the court.
Our coaches and all the entirety of the athletic department, they valued the student athlete going out to community and trying something new and getting involved in campus life.
You can get involved in so many different things. So the possibilities are truly limitless for what you can do with your college experience. You can kind of make it your own in the Division III setting. So I would encourage people who want to have flexibility to pursue different interests and passions to go D3.
Welcome back in to Esby Gymnasium on the campus of Rowan University. I'm Mark Acitelli alongside my broadcast partner, Joe Stoppenberg, here to bring you guys second half action in the NCAA Division III Men's Basketball Tournament. Your Rowan University Profs, of course, hosting the Emerson College Lions. And right now, Rowan up by one, 34-33, as we get ready, as time winding down on warm-ups, getting ready for the second half. Joe, what do you think Coach Crispin said to the team in the locker room at halftime?
I mean, obviously score more points. It's a low scoring half for the Profs that put up about 85 points per game. I think that was said, but also too, the ability to grab offensive boards, being out rebounded on the offensive side 8-2, and as a total being out rebounded 30-20. But that offensive side is gonna be key. A lot of second chance points
for Emerson College. So the Lions cashing in on them as hopefully the profs can come out and get more opportunities to try to put the ball in the bucket.
And one person on Rowan who has really struggled so far in tonight's game, Ramon Wright, surprising. 0 for 4 from the field. He has 2 total rebounds, 1 assist, 3 turnovers, and no points.
And I think that's, it might be nervousness, it might be this, it might be that. He'll find it. I think he'll find it. It's just a matter of when. And the second half is where, you know, winners win. So I think this is a perfect opportunity for him to start get going.
Well, props are certainly going to need to see Ramon Wright wake up a little bit in the second half. They have a one-point lead, and you know, Joe, once he turns it on, that could be spelling a lot of trouble for the Emerson College Lions. But the wait is over, and the second half begins. Rob DePersia brings it over half court for Rowan. He drives in, off the glass, no good, rebound, Baugh, couldn't get it, and then O'Connor comes down with it. Outlet pass to McLean, underneath to Houston, layup, got it to go. And the Profs lead gone. Now a one-point lead for Emerson. Deron Curry driving in, layup, got it to go. And make it 16 points for Deron Curry already tonight.
Just expect Mark to now say Rowan takes the lead, now Emerson takes the lead. Because that's, I feel like it's going to be for the rest of the game, just going back and forth, nobody giving an inch.
Deron Curry with the steal, Ramon Wright bringing it down the court, and there's the slam! What other way to get the big fella involved than by throwing it down?
With a little bit of authority on that dunk as well. And as we were just talking about, you need to get him going. That's a perfect opportunity to start scoring.
Houston misses it, gets his own rebound, puts it up again. And now he's fouled, so he'll get 2 free throws at the line. And that's where Rowan struggled in the first half, Joe, giving up way too many second chance points.
Jared Houston got subbed out very early in that first half because of his foul trouble. But ever since coming back into the game, he's been a dominant force down that low block.
Emerson with 9 second chance points already in tonight's game. As Houston nails the first of his 2 free throws, Prof still up by 2. Houston getting ready for his second. Puts it up and nails it. So there we go, Prof's 1-point lead now, 38-37, 18-45 left to go in the second half. Here's Nick DePersia driving in underneath, finds Ramon Wright. He gets blocked, gets his own rebound. Kicked out to Rob DePersia, 15 on the shot clock. Deron Curry from 3 off the back of the rim, rebound, Baugh. Great work right there on the offensive board. And DePersia gets the layup to go. It's Nick.
Tony, the offensive rebounds, 2 on that possession. 1 coming off of a block, but another one coming from Baugh off of the shot. More opportunities for more buckets.
And Houston up, gets the bucket to go, and 1 as he taunts the Rowan crowd. He taunted the student section over there, and they're letting him hear about it. Flexed up the muscle, and the referee's giving him warning. He's saying, don't do it again, or you're getting a tech.
Has to be. I mean, now they implemented it in the NBA when you could barely flex, and no matter what, you're going to get a technical foul called on you. I don't think it's going to be here in the NCAA, but I mean, the fact of the matter is that you don't want to be taunting the fans. Nevertheless, though, a 40-40 game.
Well, the 3-point play converted by Houston. We got a tie ball game at 40. Here's Deron Curry swatted away, but they're going to say it's a foul, and who's it on? I think it's Jared Houston.
I mean, that's one of the keys. You know, you're going to have to keep him in the foul trouble, meaning he's going to have to go off soon. If he gets another one, it's got to be very quick.
Well, Houston, it's his 3rd foul, 2 more, and he's done for the night. Deron Curry goes to the free throw line, knocks the first one down. So give Deron Curry 17 points on the night so far. Well, the funny thing is, Joe, before the game started, we were talking about the DePersia twins and Ramon Wright. And we didn't say anything really about De'Ron Curry. How about De'Ron Curry stepping up to the occasion right now, knocking down both his free throws, and now he's got 18 points.
And I think he should have been at least in the question for honorable mention. He put up some great numbers this year, but the play is absolutely tremendous coming from Curry tonight.
Houston layup no good off the backboard. Rebound Rob DePersia. Prof streaking down the court. Nick DePersia spots up from three and drops it down. 5-point lead for the Profs. And let's hope that's a sign of good things to come. Driving in, layup, got it to go, it's McLean.
It's too easy on the baseline for McLean, and you know now it's gonna be a back and forth. McLean has been all up Rowan for defense in the first half, and just like that, Curry missed the three.
Waterhouse to tie the game, got it.
Wide open once again.
Can't let them kill you in transition like that. Profs need to wake up. Rob DePersia, he answers with a three.
Whew.
It is getting hot in here.
And a lot of other players from Rowan Athletics in here. Ryan Campbell up there to show some love for Rob DePersia. Man, what a three, what an answer.
Both teams who struggled to knock down shots in the first half are knocking them down the second, and that's a travel on O'Connor. And a turnover by the Lions. It's Rowan basketball.
Rowan faithful once again, letting them hear it. As now it's a big time for a big bucket. Profs can go ahead just a little bit more.
Rob to his brother Nick. Nick DePersia gets around the screen, fakes it, finds Ramon Wright. He'll hand it off to Curry. Curry gets some space from O'Connor. Driving in, layup, and he got it! De'Ron Curry, 20 points on the night, and we still got 16 minutes left to go in the second half.
It's heating up once again. The last home game here, Curry really heated up to start the second half. Same exact situation, starting the second half and heating up.
McLean's got the ball for the Lions. Rob DePersia on him, pass it over to Waterhouse, underneath to Houston. Houston trying the post moves, layup, and another
man,
and one. Jared Houston, tell you what, he's got some fancy footwork and he's putting it on display here tonight.
Oh, absolutely, and he's really hurting the Profs inside, and with all these and ones, getting the Profs into a little hole.
Jared Houston, on the season when it comes to points per game, take a look at it, 9.6 points per game for Houston. And so far tonight, Jared Houston, he's at 9 points. But right now, he is bullying the Profs underneath the basket.
And right now, you just have to contain them. That's the one of the things in this second half you know that the Profs are going to have to do, because he's killing you right now on the inside.
And with that being said, we're going to take a quick pause for station identification. Listen to Rowan Profs basketball. Back here in Esby Gymnasium. Profs still up 50-47. Jared Houston at the line with a chance to make it a 2-point game if he can convert the 3-point play.
Curry right tonight though. As you said, 20 points. His season and career high, 27. The last time they got that was obviously this season, 27 against New Jersey City. And obviously going that way is Curry now.
Well, they have not been able to contain him all night long so far, and Rowan's hoping it stays that way. 50-48 as Houston knocks down the free throw. Curry's got the ball. Guarded by Gray. Screen set by Carney. Curry driving in. Step back jumper. No good. Rebound by Waterhouse.
A little bit of a heat check there as the Lions shooting 6-for-7 for the game. For free throw percentage, and they're not there for free throws, and they're not missing.
Waterhouse misses the jumper, and the Profs get the rebound. Rob DePersia to his brother Nick. Nick, pass to Ramon Wright, gets tipped by Waterhouse, and it will stay with the Profs in the offensive end.
And obviously you see the Profs got some height last game or this year when they came in. A couple of recruits, couple of guys, but as Carney sizes up for three, and that one's good. It shows you on the offensive side on what height can really do for a team.
Carney for three right there, and the Profs with a five-point lead. With the ball is McLean. Hands it off to O'Connor. Screen set by Holding, but O'Connor doesn't use it. Now he does. O'Connor looking to pass to somebody, finds Gray. Eight on the shot clock. Gray guarded by Nick DePersia, almost stripped, kicked out. Three-point opportunity for O'Connor, no good. And the Profs get the rebound. It's Rob DePersia bringing it up the court. Here's Rob. Rob to Carney for three again, and he knocks it down. Showing the range.
Oh, boy.
Eight-point lead for Rowan, 56-48.
Two straight threes from the big man off the bench.
Gray over to McLean. McLean driving baseline. Carney on him behind the back pass. And on the grounds, Houston. Profs come out with it. It's Nick DePersia to Rob. Rob up half court. What a dribble move. Lays it up. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? That is not human.
What did I just see?
You cannot do that. There's no way that's legal. Rob DePersia behind the back, not once, but twice. And then the underhanded layup off the top of the glass has sent this roof alight.
Mark, can you help me pick my jaw up off the floor? Are you kidding me?
I can't believe what I just saw. This place erupted. And immediately after it happened, Joe, what happened? Emerson had to call a timeout because their players needed to calm down.
Unbelievable. Rob DePersia showing off moves. This whole team is so athletic. Rob DePersia going through about three or four defenders, going right into the paint, not afraid of any contact. Man, SportsCenter top 10, here we come.
I wouldn't be surprised if it made it, to be honest. We've already had one person make it viral so far this year. That's Mac Green. He made it on Bleacher Report and all over Twitter, made it on House of Highlights Instagram. He had a huge ankle breaker where he did a behind the back. And Rob DePersia, you've got to be kidding me. You've got to be kidding me. And now Emerson's going to have to follow that up with something, or else this crowd is going to go crazy again. Gray brings it up the court. Profs with a 10-point lead, 58-48. Ball on the ground, and I can't believe it. They're going to call a foul. The Profs had the fast break, and Ramon Wright was streaking down. And you know he was about to slam it. You just know.
Mark, would you consider that play, though, with Rob DePersia, probably the play of the year? It's up there.
I have to, because look, Matt Green with the ankle breaker, that's huge. That's some highlight reel stuff. He had an open three afterwards. But he did behind the back twice, going through three defenders and then taking the fourth to the hole and making the layup with contact. That has to be the play of the year so far. And they're going to call a foul. I think it's on Matt Green.
Looked like the Rowan Athletics hype video of Rob DePersia was flashing inside and outside the locker room. Nobody knew where he was going. Nobody knew where he was. Also showing his moves. Looked like they didn't know where he was.
That's Rowan's fifth foul as a team. They're already in foul trouble early on. Pass underneath, and they're going to call another foul. And Coach Joe Crispin's not happy about the crowd raining down boos upon the court. Sixth team foul for Rowan, and that one's on Austin Carney, his second. This is exactly what Emerson needed. Houston underneath, layup, and he got it. See, now that's the problem. Rowan's got to be careful against the rim. They don't want to send him to the line for nothing. Rob DePersia, layup, no good. Carney, rebound, and put back. And the lead back up to 10.
What did I tell you? Bench. Bench presence is going to be the key today. Carney coming off of it. Tremendous game today.
Houston double team. He lost the ball, and it's a turnover. Props basketball.
Looked like Houston talking to Coach Bill Curley over there. Curley getting frustrated. The whole team right now looks frustrated.
And that is the reason why the Profs needed to win the NJAC, for the opportunity to host the first round. Carney for three. That's three in a row from the big man. 63-50 lead, and it's getting out of control here in SB. Three-pointer from Waterhouse, doesn't get it. Rebound by Carney, and whistle blown. What are they gonna say? Waiting to see what the referee calls it. Is he saying it went out of bounds? I think he's saying somehow the ball went out of bounds. It's still Rowan ball. But still, you kill momentum by doing that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Rowan had a fast break. It wasn't an open fast break, but nevertheless an opportunity to get Emerson off their feet.
Underneath to Green, no good. And then Houston with the rebound, steal from Rob. Three-pointer, he got it! Rob DePersia puts Rowan up by 16.
Fun team to watch. The hottest team in D3 hoops right now.
You gotta be kidding me. Carney fakes the three, drives in, splits the defense, doesn't get it to go. And then Rob DePersia ball hawking the rebound, puts up a three, nails it. And here come the Profs going over to the bench, getting the crowd on their feet. And it is a 16-point lead for Rowan. This is what March Madness is about, Joe Stauffenberg.
Absolutely incredible. I caught myself as a fan watching this. As Rob DePersia put up the three, I put the three up as well. Man, an exciting team to watch.
You can see the frustration on that Emerson bench right now.
The bench players
have their heads down. Curley is talking to his team. Some players are looking away. Others are listening intently. A lot of mixed emotions over there on that Lions bench.
Head coach Joe Crispin just went into the referee's huddle trying to, I guess, figure out what the call is possibly going to be or what they're talking over. But, man, the momentum from the first half to the second half, it's like a light switch. It just flipped completely.
What a game so far. And this game was really close coming into the second half. We started off the half 34-33 in a game where, Joe, both these teams couldn't hit a shot. We had a lot of balls clanking off the rim. And since then, we're still not even halfway through the second half, and it is 66-50. This Rowan offense has been on fire, dropping 32 points already in this second half.
Profs made 13 shots go down in that first half. Now they're at 25. They've almost doubled their total shots that have gone down from that first half. Only six more shots or six shots made from the first half for Emerson. But the Profs have gotten their field goal percentage up from 37 to 46. In a matter of about 9 minutes.
And after the referees leave their huddle, now they're talking about there's a timeout. What is going on out there?
Is this what they talk about with March Madness?
This is the second time the referees have taken way too long to make a decision.
And I could understand why head coach Joe Crispin is not happy. The momentum that the Profs had, obviously a timeout or two can really destroy it, but when the referees get involved, and then that's when head coach Joe Crispin doesn't like it, when they're taking some time for, I guess, whatever they need to discuss. They're trying to figure out the call, but Joe Crispin's like, hey, we got to get on the court, man. We got to keep this hand hot.
I don't blame him. But how about this for a stat, Joe? Rowan, 6-for-7 from beyond the arc in their last 7 attempts. I mean, you got to be kidding me.
Absolutely incredible.
But look,
incredible.
Here's the thing, though. are we really surprised? This Rowan team waiting to hear the foul call. They're calling a technical foul on Matt Green.
And I think they said a foul on the bench of Rowan, if I'm not mistaken.
All that time, and now O'Connor will go to the line to shoot two technical fouls for Emerson. But as I was saying, we're not surprised this Rowan team's doing this, because this is the same team that broke the school record for most three-pointers in a single game.
Yep. Yeah, 24. 24 went down, and that's going to be a record, I think, that's going to stand for a long time.
And O'Connor knocks down two free throws so far, and two out of three. So one for, I guess, the technical on the bench, and two for the technical on Matt Green. So we got a total of three, knocked two out of three down. Anyway, gets 2 points for Emerson and a free possession. Here's Gray. 14-point lead for Rowan. Martin, pass stolen away by Rob DePerge. He continues to ball hawk. Curry finds Rob. Rob dribbling through, kicks it out. Dickerson fouled going into the lane. And it was before the shot, so it's probably going to be an inbound play. And it is. Rob DePerge will inbound it for Rowan. Foul is on number four, Jack O'Connor, his third foul of the game.
Rob DePerge now with a career high in steals for a game with six.
Nick DePerge has got it outside the three-point line, drives in, layup, got it to go with the finger roll. Lead back up to 16 for Rowan. Nick DePerge on Jeffrey Gray. Emerson needs it to turn around. They needed it to turn around as quickly as possible. O'Connor, he's got Dickerson on him. Jack O'Connor trying to get around Dickerson. He's with them the whole way and then blocks the shot. Rob DePerge down the court. Here he comes. Deron Curry to Nick DePerge. Fakes the three. Dribbles in. Layup. Got it. This team's unstoppable right now.
Nick DePerge, first half, only 8 points. Right now, a total of 17 points for Nick DePerge. Absolutely incredible. We're not even halfway through the second half, and he's already doubled his first half total.
Three-pointer from Emerson quiets the crowd as Jeffrey Gray nails it. Still a 15-point advantage for Rowan.
Props are just shaking that one off, though. They made it. Oh, well, we'll come back and we'll make this one.
Deron Curry layup. A little bit too much there from Curry. Rob DePerge goes for the foul, and now they call a double dribble. Or is that a backcourt? I think he called a backcourt. And he did. It's a turnover for Emerson. Nothing going right for the Lions at the moment.
Even not even getting the steal. Rob DePerge still ball hawking and obviously causing a turnover, giving it right back to the Profs.
He is causing havoc for the Emerson Lions. Rob DePerge driving in, kicks it out. It's Dickerson. Connor Dickerson driving in, fouled going in, and then pushed at the end. And I think it's a technical. And it is a technical. Frustration foul right there on Emerson.
I believe Jeffrey Gray is going to get the technical as Rob DePerge is going to shoot the technical. So there's a technical and also a regular foul, personal foul.
Wow. Wow, so that means Gray has three fouls now. The starters on this Emerson team are really getting in foul trouble. Rob DePerge knocks down the first free throw. Look at the personal fouls from the starters, Joe. Jeffrey Gray, online, it just updated that he has four fouls. Three for O'Connor, two for Waterhouse, and three for Houston.
This is not good for Emerson College. I mean, the Profs are the ones that are doing it, though, going right at him, being aggressive, not afraid of any contact.
Right now, Profs up 71-55, a 16-point lead. And the fans letting them hear it. Rob DePerge
dribbling through again. Contested layup swatted away. And Nate Martin said a little something extra afterwards.
Rob DePerge, though, shrugging after that one. Said, all right, we'll get it back just like we have before.
Nick DePerge has got it. Guarded by Waterhouse, who's flinging his arms around, just trying to distract him. Nick DePerge for three. Are you kidding me? It's in, and a 19-point lead for Rowan.
Don't touch him. He's hot. Don't touch him.
And here's Gray driving in, layup, lost control. Ball goes to McLean, lose control again. Props come away with it, it's Carney. And Nick DePerge brings it down.
Smart play, the jump ball would have been right to Emerson.
Nick DePerge looking, driving in, brings it back out. Ryan Legler spots up off the rim. Rebound off of Rob DePerge's hand and brought down by Gray. Here's Jeffrey Gray driving in, kicked out. Waterhouse for three, contested. Great contest by Ryan Legler as it doesn't drop. Rob DePerge hands it off. Three-pointer, not again from Carney. Couldn't hit that one, though. He's still 3-for-5 from beyond the arc. Gray wide open for three. DePerge leaves him, and Gray knocks it down. Got to be careful. Can't be leaving open looks like that. Still a 16-point lead for Rowan. 8:45 left to go in the second half.
Just realizing they've been doing that, all of this, without the defensive player of the year, Ramon Wright.
Underneath to Carney. What a drive by Austin Carney, and an even better pass from Nick DePerge. 76-58, props lead, dished out. McLean to Waterhouse. Legler in his face, and he still hit it.
There's nothing that you can do about those shots. Legler, great defense, but unfortunately, I guess not enough defense.
76-61, Dickerson fakes the three, drives in baseline. Reverse layup off the backboard, he got it.
Is he from the circus tiptoeing right down the tightrope right on the baseline? They were barely giving him any space.
That is Connor Dickerson's favorite place to be, on the baseline, driving in with those acrobatic layups. Jeffrey Gray, another easy bucket. Profs need to make sure they don't give easy points back to the Lions. Still a 15-point lead. Dickerson drives again. This layup goes short of the rim, and it's rebounded. Now the Profs with this lead, you need to slow down a little bit. Jumper from holding, no good. Rebound Ryan Legler. He's got it. And Legler looking, screen set by Carney. Here's Legler. Finds Nick DePerge. Takes his time. Spots up from the RU. No good.
Profs having two 20-point scorers tonight, and there might be more. Rob DePerge only five away.
Floater, no good from the Lions. Rob DePerge gets the ball from Austin Carney, and Rowan now doing exactly what they should be doing, wasting some time, bringing it up the court. Now timeout on the floor. Let's see what it is, a full or a 30. It is a 30-second timeout. He made the signal for a 30 and a full, so we're going to keep it here. A little bit of confusion from the referees tonight. Not doing a very good job signifying to the media table whether or not it's a full or a 30. But, you know what, Joe, we love to talk.
Absolutely.
So let's keep it up. Well, right now, 15-point lead, Joe. 78-63. This Profs team is on an absolute tear right now. And Nick DePerge really heating up, 7-for-8 on his last 8 shots. And Austin Carney, 5-for-6 on his last 6.
14 points coming from Carney off the bench, 6 rebounds, a block of steal as well. But two 20-point scorers for this Profs team. Curry, 8-for-15 shooting. Nick DePerge, 8-for-14 shooting and 20 points. Deadly is one word that I can think of when it comes to these guys, both Curry and Nick DePerge, and they've been deadly tonight.
This whole Profs team, from the start of the second half, started to heat up. And since then, you know, sometimes when teams get leads, they get a little too comfortable. Well, this Profs team has kept piling it on here in the second half, and they're going to look to continue doing that as Ron Curry gets the inbound, and we're back underway.
You do have a comfortable lead now, but comfortable at They want more, just like that one.
Curry from three, and he knocks it down. 81-63, lead Balloons up to 18.
They're still firing away, Mark. No regrets.
O'Connor underneath, his pass stolen. Dickerson finds Ramon Wright looking. Pass it out, Dickerson driving in. Looking around, finds De'Ron Curry. He's got Ramon Wright out there, he drives in. Curry again, almost got it to drop off the front of the rim, but didn't get it. Gray from three, got it. And lead back down to 15.
Gray is trying to single-handedly bring the Lions back into it, but I don't think it just needs to be him. He needs help.
Yeah, certainly so. I mean, Jeffrey Gray, first team all NUMAC this year, one of the leaders on this team, and he's trying to get his team back into it, but you're right, he needs help from his other counterparts on Emerson. Justin Ventura got called for that last foul. It's his first. Now another foul, this one on McLean, and he is really unhappy about it, jumping up and down.
Surprisingly, that's his first. He's been really patient, holding things down on the defensive side as a sub right before the play starts.
Zach Waterhouse coming back into the game, the rookie of the year in the NUMAC conference, the freshman, averaging just above 16 points per game. And interesting call there. It's a push on
maybe a moving screener or something, but just trying to get some space was Curry there.
De'Ron Curry called for the foul. It's a turnover then. And Emerson basketball. 6 minutes, 4 seconds left to go in the second half. Props up 81-66.
And as I said before, they were doing all of that without Ramon Wright, the defensive player of the year. He's out there now. But still, though, the last 7-8 minutes have been without Wright. And they played probably their best basketball tonight.
O'Connor driving in, underhanded layup. Got fouled underneath. Is that on Deontay Baugh? I believe it is.
They were doing it without Deontay Baugh as well.
Yeah, Baugh was in foul trouble, and he doesn't help his case there. He's got four now after that one. O'Connor goes to the line for two.
Profs have been cool on the last four shots, only making one of them.
O'Connor misses his first free throw. On the year, from the free throw line, O'Connor shooting 89%. About to put up the second one, finally does, makes that one. But Jack O'Connor, 89% from the free throw line, he's in second place. Guess who's in first? McLean, shooting 100% from the free throw line. Hasn't missed a free throw all season long. Ramon Wright, Deontay Baugh, Dickerson fakes the three, driving baseline like we know he loves to do. Reverse layup and one.
We've seen multiple times of Dickerson driving the baseline and going up and under the bucket. He's doing that all year long, and they still have not found a solution to it. All the teams have not found a solution to it.
The grit that Connor Dickerson shows, he makes his free throw and converts the three-point play. But, Joe, we've been talking about it all year for a freshman, the poise he shows in big games, you know, just his grit, his tenacity, really makes him stand out. As Jeffrey Gray fouled, going up for the jumper, he'll go to the line for two.
And he's a freshman.
That's the crazy part.
Three more years here at Rowan.
And if he's the future of Rowan men's basketball, there's certainly going to be some bright years ahead for this team.
Absolutely. He's become a true fan favorite here at ESBY. I think the way that after he makes a great bucket, he just looks at the crowd. And he just says, let's go, like, and pumps everybody up. And that's, I mean, everybody loves, obviously, players that do that. He's one of them.
Jeffrey Gray misses his first free throw, puts up the second, knocks that one down. Prof still up by 16, 84-68, 5 minutes and 15 seconds left to go here in the second half. Nick DePersia almost walked. The bench of Emerson wanted it. They don't get it. Now he drives in, kicks out Legler. To Curry, he drives in. Leg up, underhand, got it. And now Emerson's really annoyed at the fact that a travel wasn't called.
Man, and Curry, how about it? Getting around defenders.
And a pass out of bounds from the Lions, a turnover. Cross basketball, things really unraveling for Emerson now.
When Curry jumps, he's got a big vertical. He's got a huge vertical. When he jumps, the ability his moves in the air is tremendous. It's like a Kyrie Irving. When he jumps, you don't know what he's going to do, whether he's going to pass out, put it up.
Curry driving in, layup, swatted away. But it's still going to be Pross ball. You mentioned Deron Curry. He reminds me, you're right, of Kyrie Irving with the athleticism, but he looks like Eric Bledsoe from the Bucks. He even wears number 2, which is what Bledsoe used to wear in Phoenix. I mean, they look so similar, and they do the same things. They love to drive in and get contact, and they love to spot up from 3. And right there, Deonte Ba went up for a hook shot, got fouled, he'll go to the line for 2. But I have to make that comparison. He's got the athleticism like Kyrie, but looks like Eric Bledsoe.
As that is number 5 on O'Connor.
That's a big loss for Emerson. They're already down by 18 points, and now they just lost their second leading scorer. He's actually tied for first in leading scoring with Jeffrey Gray, both of them averaging 20.3 points per game. That's a big loss for Emerson.
As you said, with Eric Bledsoe, he's going to be enjoying a new contract extension with the Milwaukee Bucks. 4 years, $70 million per Woj.
How about that?
And also Woj, too, saying that Pau Gasol going to the Milwaukee Bucks.
Ooh, that's big. The Bucks are going for it this year, but the Profs, they're also going for it this year. 1 of 2 free throws made by Deonte Ba. 87-68, three-pointer from Waterhouse in the corner. Drops down, but it's still a 16-point lead for Rowan.
Emerson has a lot of the same qualities as Rowan. They just won't quit. But right now, Rowan has a big advantage.
Nick DePersia to Ryan Legler. Back to DePersia. The Knicks got it. Driving in. Looking around. Layup. You got to be kidding me. He looked for the pass. Decided to keep it himself, switched it to his left hand, and banked it off the glass.
Got it all started with the Bob pick that got him wide open, and there was nobody in the paint, too.
Jeffrey Gray's three-pointer no good, and there was no one to rebound for Emerson, brought down by Deonte Ba. Dickerson driving in, stripped from behind. Still going to be Rowan ball as Waterhouse poked it away.
Could have been one or two fouls there as, once again, Dickerson was walking the tightrope, but that time it was on the far court, but still, the ability to stick with it. The ball got poked away, but still, Pross will maintain possession.
And we have a timeout on the floor. Still no indication of whether it's a full or immediate timeout. No surprise there, so we're going to keep it here again. And right now, it's all Rowan Pross. 89-71, 18-point lead. 3 minutes, 37 seconds left to go. We must mention, in the first round game before this one, Nichols College took on Middlebury College, and Nichols got the 74-71 victory, and we stayed for the end of that game, Joe. That was a back-and-forth affair as well, and that means Nichols moves on to the second round, plays the winner of this one. If everything holds the way it is right now, Rowan will host Nichols here in the second round for a chance to move on to the third round of the NCAA tournament.
Middlebury put up a tremendous fight over Nichols. Nichols about 14th in the nation right now. And, you know, Nichols was down at 10 one point. Actually, a few points in that game that Nichols fought, and they took a 10-point deficit going into half, too. But they fought back and obviously won that game. It just shows how tough that team can be. Obviously, being ranked is you know they're not an easy team, but fighting back from 10 points, not an easy thing to do.
Dickerson underneath finds Ba. Ba looking, post move, swatted away. Good block by Houston. Ba needs to be careful. One more foul, and he's done for the night. Waterhouse for 3, hand in his face. No good, but they're going to call a foul on Ryan Legler, and he can't believe it.
Wright and Ba both have to be careful. They both have 4. But it shows, you look at Wright, you know, we talk about how his defensive awareness really gets other teams struggling. Right now he's struggling on the offense because he can put it up on offense too, but just shows that if one guy's down, another guy's going to step up. Yeah. This guy tonight, I think, is going to be is Carney. Although, you know, Curry has 25, Nick DePersia has 22, but Carney coming off the bench, a big man coming off the bench, having 14 points, 3-for-5 shooting from beyond the arc, and 6 rebounds.
Well, Deontay Bye exits the game. Rob DePersia comes back in. Speaking of Austin Carney, he checks into the game for Rowan. So far, Waterhouse hit 2 of his 3 free throws, looking to hit his third, and it would cut the deficit for Emerson to 15. Waterhouse knocks it down. He nails all 3, and it's an 89-74 lead for Rowan.
I think right now all you need to do is try to waste as much time. You want to put some points up, but make sure it's a good bucket.
De'Ron Curry driving baseline, pass out. Dickerson fakes it. Jumper, no good. Rebound brought down by Gray.
That's a good shot. Dickerson was wide open. Wasted some clock. He didn't get it down to 1. But still, though, an opportunity for the Profs to maybe try to extend it. Fortunately, couldn't cash in.
Ball movement from Rowan has been amazing all game long, and that was a perfect example. Shot just didn't go down. Waterhouse can't get it. Rebound. No good as the shot falls because the rebound went off the fingertips of Houston and hit the beam that's holding up the net. And then it dropped in, so the bucket won't count, and it'll be Rowan Profs basketball.
Man, that was close.
Profs catch a break right there. Still a 15-point lead. We're under 3 minutes left to go in the second half. Profs need to see this one through in order to make it through to the second round. Rob DePersia to Austin Carney for 3 off the rim. Brought down by Gray. Profs need to make sure they make Emerson waste as much time as possible. 3-pointer, no good. Rebound brought down by Nick DePersia. And ball's going to be Profs ball anyway after the whistle's blown. Is that they're calling an over the back? Maybe an over the back. No foul issued to anybody, so interesting. Nonetheless, Profs basketball. Austin Carney finds Nick DePersia. DePersia takes it to half court, doing the smart thing, trying to kill some time. Carney driving in, kicks out Ryan Legler, the sharpshooter. Can't make the 3, hits the rim, rolls out. Rebound by Gray. 2 minutes left to go in the second half. 15-point lead for Rowan. Gray hits an open 3. And it's 89-77. It's a 12-point lead for Rowan, but Emerson chipping away.
Slowly but surely at it. And that's going to be the issue. The Profs right now need to step up on defense. Last 2 minutes. Need to, you know, this is where defense wins championships. Obviously not going for a championship, but on the road to a national championship, Profs need to step up.
Well, at first they had that play changed to a 2. Said Jeffrey's foot was on the line, but they have since put it back to a 3, so it is still a 12-point game.
Profs, this is the 13th appearance all time in the NCAA tournament. The last time that the Profs had a tournament game, 2000 against Franklin and Marshall, lost that one 76-72. Head coach at the time was the assistant head coach right now, head coach Joe Cassidy.
Hey, I mean, when you got some, and Joe Cassidy, he won a national championship with Rowan in 1996. That's Rowan's one and only national title. Joe Cassidy was the head coach there that defeated Hope by a final score of 193. It's really good to have someone who's been through this before on the bench for your team. DePersia driving in, gets the layup to go, and the lead up to 14. And it's really good, especially because this is Coach Joe Crispin's first NCAA appearance as a coach. So it's good to have Coach Cassidy over your shoulder. Nick DePersia passes it to Connor Dickerson, open layup.
Didn't even look like he tried on that bucket.
And now a 16-point lead for Rowan. Almost stripped away and then stolen. Here's Nick DePersia making sure he doesn't lose the ball. Driving in, layup off the glass, no good. Carney looking for the rebound and a foul's called.
Might have been a push trying to get away from the defender there.
Well, they're going to call it on Austin Carney, it looks like.
Number 25, they did just signal it. That's Carney's third. But with a minute and 11 seconds left, that doesn't really matter. So right now, minute and 11 left in the game, second half. Profs up by a substantial amount, 16-point lead, 93-77. And Nick DePersia gets subbed out. Marco Pantovich comes into the game for some defense. And DePersia gets a standing ovation from the Esby crowd.
Profs have scored 59 points here in this second half. And it just shows how that second half, something is set in the locker room by head coach Joe Crispin that gives the Profs more points in that second half.
How about the hustle right there from Waterhouse? Didn't get on the first shot, got his own rebound, didn't get on the second, but third time's the charm as he knocked it down. Profs still up 14 with a minute left. Timeout on the floor. 93-79. It's a full timeout. A clear signal this time from the officials at the scorer's table. But because we're under 2 minutes, Joe, we're going to keep things here. And, Joe, you can't say enough about how this Rowan Profs team handled their first NCAA tournament game in 19 years.
First half, they were struggling. But this second half, I could say they handled it with ease. And it's just been the hands from Deron Curry and Nick DePersia who've really led this team all year, almost all year. And obviously coming up in a couple of clutch situations, a couple of clutch threes. The way that Deron Curry started the second half, once again, the last time that we were in Esby, he started the second half out hot. And obviously started out hot, and the Profs haven't looked back.
Certainly haven't. And how about this, Joe? You look at the Profs. They average 10.2 steals per game. They have 16 steals tonight as a team. And I think the discrepancy between the two teams has to be the turnover count. Profs really took care of the basketball tonight on the season, averaging 16.3, only 11 turnovers tonight. Emerson on the air averaging 14. They've turned the ball over 25 times here in Esby Gymnasium tonight.
And another stop from Rob DePersia, which the defender runs right into him.
And Rob DePersia gets fouled, which means he'll go to the line for two shots, as that is the ninth team foul on the Emerson Lions. 58.3 seconds, and these two free throws could very well seal this game for Rowan.
I mean, we're just barely under a minute.
Knocks down the first. They did say it was a 1-1. So he gets a chance at a second. And coming out of the game, Jeffrey Gray. First team all NUMAC for the Emerson Lions. Also a senior leader on this team. And the Emerson faithful giving him a standing ovation as he comes out for what is most likely his final game as an Emerson Lion.
All season he's, you know, led this Emerson College team.
And Rob DePersia, he exits the game now, and he gets an even bigger standing ovation, this one from the Rowan faithful. Now, talking to Rob yesterday, playing for this team means so much to him and his brother Nick, and they leave their hearts out on the floor every time they play. And they both have showed out tonight. Nick DePersia with 14 points, while Rob, he's got 17. So between the two DePersia twins, 41 out of the Profs 95. Couldn't have asked for a better game from the two brothers.
As it's a rebound by the Profs. Victor Ruggiano got the breakaway steal as they foul him. And, you know, Mark, it says they mean a whole lot to them playing together, playing on this stage. And they play their heart out every game. I want to, you know, talk about one of the greatest players ever to put on a Sixers uniform, Allen Iverson. He always played the game like his last, and right now it's every game. Rob and Nick DePersia are playing it like their last, which it could be possibly their last game every single time out if they keep going with it. And they don't want to go out right now. They do not want to exit out. This team wants to go far.
Now, and I talked to Rob yesterday, and he said he wants to make a deep run. And him and his brother, as well as the rest of the Profs,
are going to do everything they can to make sure that they get every little bit out of themselves for the rest of the season and into this NCAA tournament. Ruggiano hit 1 out of 2 free throws, 96-79 props, a 17-point lead, 30.2 seconds left in the game. McLean heads to the line, Joe, and like I said, he hasn't missed a free throw all season long.
Obviously this hole.
And there it goes. Curse of the commentator never fails. McLean misses his first free throw.
I was about to talk about how the couple of the free throws could really help him to try to come back in this game, but 30 seconds, chances are dwindling down by a lot.
McLean misses the second as well. Has not missed a single free throw all season long, and right at the end of the season, misses both. And here's Ruggiano. Legler has the ball for Rowan. Step back. 12 on the game clock, and he's dribbling it out. There's more time on the game clock than the shot clock. Esby Gymnasium starting to rise. Thatcher tries to pass it in to Legler. Ball tipped out of bounds. And everyone on their feet now. 3.5 left to go. 17-point lead for Rowan after the inbound. They've been waiting for this. Legler not fouled, dribbling out the clock, and that's gonna do it. How about that? Your Rowan University props, first time in the NCAA tournament in 19 years. Come back and make a big statement here in Esby with a 96-79 victory over the Emerson College Lions. And if Nichols College is in the stands right now watching this game, the props have put the Bison on notice.
Oh, they have to. They put all of the teams in the NCAA on notice with that one. I mean, putting up the most points out of all the games, or obviously the two games so far right now, but man, 96-79, that's a huge victory. Not just putting, Nichols College,